Hi, this is Bobbie Jean Brown, and you've been listening to Blevins Nation. Wow! Well, swinging on the front porch, swinging on the lawn, swinging where we want, cause there ain't nobody home. Swinging to the left and swinging to the right, think about baseball, I'm swinging all night, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Swinging in the living room, swinging in the kitchen, most folks don't cause they're too busy bitching. Swinging in there cause you want me to beat it, so I mixed up the batteries. She left the beat. I scream, you scream, we all scream.
Blevins Nation Entertainment and BlevinsNation.com, the place to go for all the best in rock and roll music, new rock, and podcast. So sit back, hold tight, and open up your ears. The revolution is here. Now here's your host, Chris.
All right, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Yes, we got Bobbie Jean Brown. That's right, from the Great White videos, the Hurricane videos, and of course, that infamous Warrant Cherry Pie video, where she warmed the hearts of millions of young boys around the world. But so great talks with her. Had a little bit of technical difficulty with the beginning, but we were talking about Janie and their daughter and some other things. So anyway, that will not be on here. It goes straight into talking about just some other things. So I'm sorry about that, but sometimes technical difficulties happen. And anyway, without any further ado, here is Mrs. Bobbie Brown, Bobbie Jean Brown. Miss Cherry on Top is her new book, so check it out.
Do my, when I perform or whatever, and she replied with, we don't provide pet sitters. And I was like, that's not really what I'm asking. You know, I was kind of hoping for more because I was more than willing to go. But then that's what they said. And so I was just like, all right, well, then I can't leave. And so then I'm paying them back currently.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Not going to ask who that is. I kind of have an idea. But anyway.
Yeah. Yeah. So, it, you know, oh, well.
Yeah. Yeah.
I couldn't.
Well,
you know, I couldn't leave. So,
yes.
Yeah, I totally so I'm paying them back, but that's okay.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I get it, you know, and things happen. But, you know, some people just don't have it, compassion, I guess, and, you know, whatever.
And everybody has their own, to each their own. Maybe mine's more than some, you know, would consider a priority, but, you know, my pet, my family, my loved ones are definitely my priority above work.
Oh, yes.
So, you know, so I had to do what I had to do, but I'm sorry I missed you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, exactly. So, but, you know, question, what got you into stand-up?
Well, I talk about that in the new book.
Okay.
Basically, I fell down my stairs last year and hit my head table first, and then my body, and the doctor said, had I hit it like a centimeter to the center of my head on that vein that goes down the middle of your forehead, I would have died instantly.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, and I had black eyes for months, and I still have a dent in my forehead. Like, it definitely did something. And, and it just kind of freaked me out, you know. My brother had just moved away to Minnesota, and I kind of felt alone in the world. I was like, I don't have a boyfriend, I'm single, who would I call? You know, people in LA aren't the most reliable. you know, it's not easy to make good friends here.
Yeah.
You know, I have some, but everybody has their own lives, and I just kind of had a, you know, what am I doing with my life kind of epiphany. And just decided to start checking off all of the boxes on my bucket list, kind of like, you know what? We don't have that much time. I just had a brush with death. I need to, you know, do something. Plus, I was depressed. I didn't meet my brother, and my nephew just moved, and I just felt like I just need to start getting busy and helpful and do all the things that I've always been scared to do now, because, you know, we're not awarded time in our lives. So, and that was a reminder of that. And so I just decided to just start doing all the things that scared the crap out of me, or that I always wanted to do, you know?
Yeah.
And that's how I got into doing comedy.
Okay. You know, that's really brave, especially comedy, because, you know, I'm a musician and I have to have a guitar with me on stage or I feel naked. And, that's my security blanket, I guess. When you're doing comedy, you don't have a security blanket.
It's horrifying.
Blanket. Oh my
God. Yeah, it's horrifying. Yeah, it can be very horrifying. I mean, literally, I get anxious and have like meltdown the day of a performance. I'm just like, oh, and all this self-doubt and all this stuff I'm telling myself, how crazy I am.
Why am I doing this?
Why am I doing this to myself? Oh my God. And then, you know, I'll have a great show and then be like, okay, that was cool. And then everybody's like, that was awesome. And I'm like, okay, so I'm actually doing this. I'm doing this. You know, however, I'm not devoted to it in the way that other comedians are, because I have so many other things that I pursue and that I'm interested in and do.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just one of the, I guess I'm a jack of all trades. I guess it's just one of the many things that I'm trying right now and seeing what transpires from that, you know, if something good comes from it.
Okay. Okay. Very cool. And you mentioned that you talk about that in your new book, and your new book is titled, is it Cherry on Top? Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Give us a little bit on that. You know,
okay.
What it came from.
Okay, so essentially the first book, Dirty Rocker Boys, is an autobiography.
Right.
And I leave you at the time of my life when I'm doing Ex-Wives of Rock. It's right after Janie passes, and this is like around 2014. So there's never been an autobiography that has a part two, essentially, and this mine is probably the first one. And I'm happy because I still have so many other stories to tell. Plus, I had so many people messaging me, asking me questions, wanting to fill in the blanks, wanting to know more, having, you know, asking me advice, like pouring in of questions. And so essentially, I pick up where I left off from the last book and lead you to my current status and answer all the questions and fill in all the blanks of the voids that I maybe didn't get to touch on completely in the first book. Mm-hmm. And so basically it's a continuation of that book to now.
Well, you know, that kind of makes sense, you know, like you said, that there's no, you know, autobiography that's a two-part series. But with you hitting your head and the near-life experience and things changing in your life, it was almost a have to, you know?
Yeah. So, I mean, right after I wrote the first book, I thought, you know, I still have so much more to talk about. And I said it to my book company, and they were like, autobiographies don't have more than one book. There's no, you know, so they rejected the idea.
Oh, wow.
Time passed, and then I brought it up, you know, a couple years later, because so much stuff happens to me in my life. It's kind of crazy. I draw a lot of weird attention sometimes, and my daughter always says, you and Dad have the craziest fans of any people I know, like just the most bizarre stories. And so I reached out to Rare Bird, which is a more independent book company, and they were totally interested, and so I was like, good, yay. So I brought Caroline Ryder, my initial ghostwriter from the first book, in on this writing adventure the second time, because, you know, she and I do so well together. And so we went down the rabbit hole again.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
You know, and I can't find it anywhere around here in stores. Now, you can get it online, like at, I guess, Barnes & Noble and different places like that. But I actually want to walk in and grab it, pick it up, and walk out with it. That's just me, how I am. Is it...
What's your zip code? I can probably find the stores. There's a site online that will tell you which bookstores that the book is at in your city.
Right. I looked at that, and that's why I went to Barnes & Noble, but they didn't have it at the one I went to. So. So, yeah, I actually did find that. So, so that's very cool.
You can get it on Amazon.
Yeah, I know. Like I said, I want to walk in, though, and grab it. I hate ordering.
What about audiobooks? My audiobook comes out, I recorded it myself again.
Really?
September 18th.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think that those are, they're so much better because it's like I'm talking to a friend, and it's really different because writing the book and telling the story to my ghostwriter and actually reading it and having to feel it all as I'm recording it is a whole nother ball of wax. Like, and you totally hear the emotion on the, you know, there's times where I'm like, should we do that again? And they're like, no, that was awesome because I get all choked up. And so I feel like, it's almost better because then you get to hear it from my voice, like I'm reading you a bedtime story, but with acting the emotion out, but it's sincere. So it's hard to describe. I feel like it's a more personal, intimate account of the book.
Okay. Yeah. And you know, people can actually plug, you know, everybody now, every car, you plug your phone in and you can run it through your stereo. So, I mean, and you can listen to it driving down the road. I mean, that's awesome. That's a great idea. Okay. Very cool.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's see here. Now, is the other book still available to get?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Both of them.
All right. Yeah. All right. Very cool. And, I know you can get all those on, Amazon and all that good stuff, but, definitely going to check out the audio book. That's cool. Now, did you do the first one that way? The Rocker Boys?
I did. If you want a person, if you want it signed, like a copy of the book signed, you can just go to my website because I sign them personally to people who purchase them there.
At
BobbieJeanBrown.net. Yeah. BobbieJeanBrown.net.
Yeah. I've actually been there. So, and I thought about ordering it through there, but I wasn't sure if you autographed them or not. So, okay.
I do everything myself.
Okay. Awesome. Awesome. Yeah. I mean, sometimes that's the only way to do it. You know, my wife calls me a control freak, but hey, you know. That's...
Yeah. Yeah. I don't have to kind of like the hiring studies right now, that's for sure.
Very cool. Okay, awesome, Matt. Now, let's, if you got a few more minutes, let's talk about music.
Sure.
Okay. What, you know, you were in, let's see, Hurricane Video, two Great White videos, of course. Someone even posted, it's ironic, somebody posted last night about the, you know, this was the 8th was the, you know, anniversary for Cherry Pie coming out. And I wrote something on there about, yeah, you know, that Bobby warmed the hearts of all young men from that video.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. And, you know, probably other things too, but anyway, it's something else. But, you know, it's, that puts you on, I guess, not, I guess the radar or whatever, you know, but,
in music, yeah.
Yeah. You know, and, but you had been in, you know, a few videos before that. So, but what, were you into rock music at the time or was it just a gig?
I was not.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I liked to dance. I liked hip hop or pop music. I grew up on country music I liked rock a little bit in high school, but it was more of like, when MTV came around, that's when it changed everything.
Yes.
Back then, you know, MTV came on and it was like, oh, wow. You get exposed to everything. And then it was all about the music video. So that's when I really became interested in any kind of rock music, but I was not like a diehard rock fan.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, very cool. Now, what are you listening to nowadays?
I listen to like R&B, hip hop, some rock, I'm still not like a hardcore rock fan.
Okay.
I like some rock music. I like a little bit of everything, honestly. Like now, these days, I literally listen to every genre of music and make my own playlist and just listen to it, you know, listen to that.
Well, there you go. That's cool.
I don't listen to the radio because I feel like they play the same 10 songs over and over.
Of course they do. You know, that's how those get popular that aren't any good.
Yeah, I can't stand it, so I refuse to listen to, like, any radio station. I just go to Spotify, and I'll check out every week, I'll check out the new releases in every category, and if I like the song, I'll add it to my playlist, and then I'll just start listening to a new playlist.
Oh, okay. That's cool. That's interesting. I like that.
And I get to, you know, I'm introduced to all different kinds of artists and genres of music, and you know, I think I have good taste in music, so usually when I play a playlist for my friend, they're like, "That song's awesome. Who is that?" I'll be like, "I have no idea, no clue who it is, because I don't remember, because I make a new one every week." But
cool. That's cool. Yeah. The age of digital and radio and stuff like that, and streaming is just amazing how it has changed everybody's life, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Now here's the big question. Have you been asked to be in a video lately? Or would you be in one?
I have. I was in a Steel Panther video.
No way. Which one?
I've been in a few.
Okay. Okay.
I'm on the cover of their last album. And
I did not know that. And, okay.
Yeah, and I'm in their little mini movie. I play the guy's mom. What's the one with the really, really long hair? I can't even think of his name right now.
Oh my gosh, he's the bass player. Is he the one that's the pretty guy?
I play his mom. Yeah, I play his mom. And
I have seen that. Okay. I did not know that was you. That's crazy.
Yeah, that's me. And then also I just did another one of their videos like 2 days ago.
Oh, okay. Okay. Very cool. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I didn't expect that, you know, with everything else you had going on to be, you know, still doing that. That's awesome. That's very cool. So
yeah. Thank you.
Oh yeah, no problem. Well, you know, I guess I'll let you get off of here. Everybody, like I said, you know, like she said, you can go to her website. It's is it BobbieJeanBrown.net?
Yes, BobbieJeanBrown.net, and you can follow me on Instagram at BrownBobby or Twitter at @BobbieJeanBrown, and I'm Bobbie Jean Brown across all other social media platforms, and or listen to my podcast at www.BobbieAndCharissePodcast.com.
Yes, definitely. That's and I think that's on some other iTunes or not, but whatever it is now.
I think it's direct URL. Right,
oh, it's
now,
just a direct URL. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. For some reason, I was thinking it was on something else, but okay.
No, it's funny. If you want to laugh about some stuff, you'll get a kick out of it.
Well, I saw you on a radio interview with a lady, and I don't think it was too long ago, and it was very cool. I can't remember her name.
McDonald.
Yes, I think so.
It's called Pissy Scoop. Right?
Yes, I think so. Yeah, right. You and her were in
at a rock studio?
Yes, I think so.
Oh, that's Michaela. Okay.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay. But yeah, everybody, you can check that out and definitely go get the book. Get both of the books, and if you buy them direct from her website, then she will autograph them. So That's very cool.
Yeah. Be sure to email me the link so I can share it when it comes out.
I will. And thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Thank you so much, Chris.
Oh, yeah. Have a good one.
Have a great day.
You too. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, that about wraps it up, everybody. This is the 103rd episode of BlevinsNation.com. I want to definitely thank Bobbie Jean Brown for coming on the show. Great talks, awesome stuff. You know, like I said, we had to cut out the first because I had some technical difficulties. And what she was talking about when we came right in was she was talking about Killfest, where someone would not let her bring her dog that had just had babies and had been sick and ill. I forgot what all, you know, she had said. And anyway, it she didn't want him to babysit her dog. She just had to have her dog with her. And when they were rude about it, she just kind of backed out and said, no, I'm not going to do Kill Fest. But and that was over in Columbus, Ohio. And yes, I did go to that. That was very cool. And she wasn't there, and that kind of sucked. I thought she was going to be. But yeah, maybe one day I'll catch up with her. And go to her website, BobbieJeanBrown.net. Order both of her books. Her first book is Dirty Rocker Boys. Second book is Cherry on Top, and if you order from her website, she will autograph them for you. So that is great stuff. I can't wait to catch her her comedy act, which she doesn't do a lot of, but you know. Also, get prepared. Do not forget about that Steel Panther video that she's coming up in, a new one she's coming up in, and she was in one just not too long ago, which was the little mini movie thing that they did for the release of the new album coming up. But anyway, check Bobbie Jean Brown out on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and all that good stuff, and keep her in your memories, so to speak. Anyway, yes, loved all those videos. Desert Moon was really, man, she was looking hot in that video, too. She looked hot in all the videos. She looked good when she was on that Star Search thing back in the day. And, of course, you know, being from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, she's a neighbor of mine, me being from, you know, Pearl, Jackson area, Mississippi. So, very cool stuff. Bobbie Jean, thank you, and all the best to you and your daughters. And, anyway, everybody, remember to check out BlevinsNation.com, Blevins Nation on YouTube, on, let's see, what else, iHeartRadio, iTunes, Spotify, you know, all the places you can download, but also I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all these social media. And go check all that out, and don't forget to check out Voodoo 13, that's right, V13official.com, baby. And be on the lookout for next one coming up is Mr. King. That's right, Danny King, original drummer for the band Lillian Axe. So get ready for that coming up in just a few days. Thank y'all so much, and hope you enjoy the rest of Cherry Pie. 10 miles wide, looks so good, bring a tear to your eye. Sweet cherry pie, yeah. Swing it to the drum, swing it to guitar, swing it to the bass in the back of my car. Ain't got money, ain't got no gas. We can get where we're going if we swing real fast. I'll scream, you'll scream, we all scream for her. Don't even talk, cause you can't ignore her. She's my cherry pie. Cool drink of water, such a sweet surprise. Tastes so good, make a grown man cry. Sweet cherry pie, oh yeah. She's my cherry pie. Put a smile on your face, 10 miles wide. Looks so good, bring a tear to your eye. My daughter no more.